Hey guys, how are you doing? This is Kali from Tech Fanciers, and this is video from the series of exclusive for Condor. So in this video we will taking a look at MIUI 8 on our cool device Moto E Condor. Well, this is the story of MIUI development for our Moto E Condor. 2 months back, the developer Simo Master 1 released the first build of MIUI 8. That is Marshmallow 6.0.1. The most of the things are working well. Also, I leave the link of this MIUI 8 ROM in the description. You can download and install. First boot always doesn't work, so reboot once again. Also, the second boot took so long, so be patient. After all set, you will get this screen. You have the MIUI 8 on this Moto E Condor. I'm not the fan of MIUI or Zenfone or Samsung's touch face or whatever. I always go with stock Android, but while seeing the MIUI on this device, it's really admiring and wonderful. From the power off menu to the smart touch feature, everything is cool and really responsive and impressive. You can use the MIUI themes with this ROM. Most of the things working perfect. Battery performance, the phone stability is great. But you can't use this ROM as a primary or daily driver. Well, lot of reasons are there, but I will tell you some of them. This ROM doesn't have the G apps inbuilt. The ROM like Pixel Experience has the G app inbuilt, with that it comes nearly 4 to 500 MB, but this MIUI comes nearly 600 something without any G app integration. That's kind of incompatible thing for this device. Also, I'm not tried to install any G apps on this ROM because I won't use this ROM. That's what the reality. And most of the time the SIM card is not getting detected, but sometimes the signal is working, but most of the time not. After all the things, the main problem of this ROM is offline charging. Some of you guys didn't know how serious this problem is. In some case, you just drain your battery to zero and it's powered down, right? And you are trying to charge your phone. It works in other ROM, but not in this. You can't get your phone charged and turn on back. Eventually, our Moto E Condor has inbuilt battery, so you can't manually charge your battery. The date arrives. Yeah. Also, my suggestion while installing this kind of ROMs, please have the good battery backup. Don't try in low battery. So yeah, that's kind of video for this. If you get something useful, just leave a like and subscribe to this channel to get videos for our device Moto E Condor. Thank you for watching this. I will see you guys in my next good one. Code Moto.